Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand to everybody. Jai Sachidanand. We will start our Parayan of Pratikaman.
Page 59. Questioner. Does Artha Dhyan or Rodra Dhyan arise when we see faults in others? Dada Shri. Yes. A person will see faults in others if that is the filled karmic stock within, which he has brought forth. Even then, he himself, Pote, the developing eye, is not at fault. He, Chandubai, should do pratikraman, such that, why is this happening? That should not happen. That's it. Whatever karmic stock he has filled in his past life, that is what will come out. That is what we refer to as filled karmic stock in our simple language.
Barelomal, in our language. Stock in a reserve tank. So for ourselves, our as a Mahatma, we have no Artha Dhyan, no Rodra Dhyan. But discharge result of Artha Dhyan or discharge Rodra Dhyan. So we have to ask file one to do pratikaman. So it will convert into dharma dhyan.
Suppose 7 to 8 people show up at night and they call out, is Chandubai there? It is 11:30 at night. So what do you say? They are from your hometown.
We have to now visualize what happened.
Of the group, one or two of them are your acquaintances, and the rest of them are those people's acquaintances. So in total, they are a group of 10 to 12 people, and they call out for you. So what do you tell these people at 11:30 at night? Would you open the door or not? Page 60. Questioner. Yes, I would. Dada Shri. And then, what would you tell these people? Would you turn them down? Questioner. No, no. How could I turn them down? Dada Shri. Then what would you tell them? Questioner. I would invite them in. Come on in. Dada Shri. Come, welcome, welcome. It is in our culture, isn't it? So you say, come, welcome, and seat them on your sofa set. If your child is sleeping on the sofa, you quickly wake him up and set him aside. You seat them down on the sofa. However, in your mind, you think, why have these dratted people come at this hour? Now, this is not Artha Dhyan, it is Rodra Dhyan. You spoil your inner intent, bhav, towards the other person. Whereas in Artha Dhyan, one himself suffers the pain that is meant for him. Whereas in this case, not only are you taking on the externally induced suffering that is not yours to begin with, but you are also blaming other people for it. Why have these dratted people come at this hour? Even then, what do you say? Your inculcated values would not let you off, would they? You quietly say, a little bit, a little bit. But hey, a little bit of what? Then you say, would you like a little bit of tea?
We can visualize what happened really in our worldly life.
Then, if the guests are so disposed, they will say, Chandubai, leave the tea aside right now. Make a simple hot meal instead. That would be more than enough. Imagine, with that, your wife's train of thoughts gets started up. What will end up happening in the kitchen? Now, what is the Lord's directive, Agna? What should the person who wants to go to moksha do? The inner intent, of why have these dreaded people come at this hour will definitely arise in a person. Currently, the pressure of the current era of the time cycle, the environment is such that this will arise in a person. It will happen even to a mature person. So why are you creating such a cause from within? You are doing good on the outside, while spawning ill intents within. Meaning that, by welcoming them in cordially, you are suffering the effect of the past life. Whereas with the latter, the ill intent, you are binding anew for the next life. On account of what is taking place within, through the ill intent of why have these dreaded people come at this hour, you are binding anew.
In our Akram science, bad thing happened outside, we are doing pratigman inside. So we are changing our cause for next life. And by practicing five agna, we are charging such way that we can achieve Mahavidyakshetra and moksha. So worldly people, they are showing outer side good and inside they are binding bad karma. While in our Mahatma's life, outside they may have anger or something happened to them with a family member, they hurt family member or become angry on family, but inside they are doing pratikaman. So they are improving inside and outside remain as it is. So by doing pratikaman, we can change our inner intent and everything.
So there, you should ask the Lord for forgiveness by saying, Lord, I have made a mistake. Due to the pressure of circumstances, I spoke in this way, but this is not my desire. It's fine if they stay. If you erase this, then that is considered to be effort, purushard.
In ignorance stage, this type of pratikaman they can do. They don't know exactly pratikaman, but they can do like this, oh God, this is my mistake. Due to circumstantial evidence, I have made this mistake. This is wrong. I should not do. This is not my wish. So negative thoughts come from mind and ego, heartily he can apology for these negative thoughts of mind. So he can improve and it is called positive effort for next life.
Something like this will certainly happen. This happens to even those people who seem to have control over their senses. The current era of the time cycle is strange in this way. However, if you erase it, then you will get the result accordingly.
So he doesn't have knowledge of self-realization. Still, he can improve inside and he can change their causes for next life.
Questioner, ordinarily, within an hour, 5 to 25 atikraman end up happening. Dada Shri, do collective pratikraman for that. Do it collectively. Say, I am doing collective pratikraman. Questioner, how should I do that? What should I say? Dada Shri, many of these atikraman have happened, so I am doing collective pratikraman for them. Specify your topic, that it is on this topic, and I am doing collective pratikraman for that. So it gets resolved. And even then, if some were still to remain, then you will wash it off later. Page 62. It will get washed off later. But do not procrastinate on it. If you procrastinate, then it may be left pending entirely. There is no need to complicate the matter.
So your intent has changed heartily. This is wrong. I should not do this. After 20, 40 negative or atikraman taken place, still your heartily apology for that. Once or collectively you are doing pratikraman, still you can improve and you can wash out that negative thoughts or atikramans.
Chapter 14, heading, release from the bondage of anger, pride, deceit, greed. Questioner, if a great deal of anger arises towards someone, and then after verbally lashing out at that person, I become quiet. Later on, I feel a lot of internal turmoil because of what I said. So then, do I need to do pratikraman more than once for that? Dada Shri, if you do pratikraman wholeheartedly, 2 to 3 times, if it is done very precisely, then it's over. You should say, oh Dada Bhagwan, I took it too seriously. Intense anger arose. The other person must have been hurt so much. I'm asking the person for forgiveness with you as my witness. I am deeply, fervently asking for forgiveness.
Do 2-3 times is okay, but it should be heartily and correctly.
Questioner, when prolonged arguments have occurred with someone, then it keeps creating a distance with the other person. Sometimes, 1 or 2 pratikramans are done, whereas other times, pratikraman needs to be done 4 or 5 times, or even more than that. So if I do it just 1 time, then would it cover everything? Dada Shri, do as many as you can, and ultimately, do collective pratikraman. If a lot of pratikraman accumulate, then do it collectively by saying, I am not able to do pratikraman for all of these karma. I am doing pratikraman for all of these together. You should tell Dada Bhagavan so it reaches him. Questioner, when I become angry with someone, then I do pratikraman immediately. But even then, the effect of our anger on the other person does not become negated right away, does it? Page 63. Dada Shri, you should not concern yourself with whether it is negated or not. You should just keep washing your clothes and keep clean. You do not like it within. Nevertheless, it ends up happening, doesn't it? Questioner, anger ends up happening. Dada Shri, therefore, do not worry about that. You should continue doing pratikraman. You should say, Chandubai, do pratikraman. Then, as soon as the cloth is soiled, he will wash it. Do not become overly involved in this. Otherwise, it will become spoiled once again for you.
This is scientifically. Keep separation. And Chandubai may wash properly or some little bit. It remains, don't worry for that. From your side, keep separation one thing. And you ask Chandubai to do pratikraman. This is second part. This is our science.
Pooja Siddhartha is explaining about the collective pratikraman.
Yes.
She's saying like you can do whatever you can. And then do it collective pratikraman. So we'd like to understand the limit or the boundary where we should keep on doing the pratikraman and where we can do the collective pratikraman.
Simply, we know which are the mistakes made by us towards that person. Do individual pratikraman.
Correct.
And then we cannot remember how much mistake we have made. Then do collectively pratikraman. But whichever you know, the anger or some words, bad words to that person, insulting that person, negativity of that person, each and every possible mistake, you do pratikraman for each and every mistake. Whatever you know, you can understand about this type of mistake I have made for that person. And then you doesn't remember properly, something happened with that person, but I don't know that evidence and which type of mistake I have made in past, then do collectively. This type of mistake I have made, but that person hurt by me and this is very wrong. I should not do this. This is my mistake. I should not hurt that person. Do collectively.
Shouldn't I make it very serious, like I then keep on watching what is my mistake and what is my expectation, and then I'm trying to see, but I'm not able to see, and still I try to see more and more and more, and then I go into the kind of suffering that why I'm not staying in Nan, what's happening to me. So what should be the limit?
Really, first thing, myself, what I am doing, I am pure soul and Deepak is separate. So I will ask this, so you find out which are the mistake you have made with that person. Whatever he remember, he says this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then I don't remember now. Okay, you individually 5 mistake you do pratikaman. And then for other mistake, do collectively. So he is happy and I am happy. If I say my mistake and I have to find out, then it gives stress and botheration to us. But really, I am not. See, here simple Dada Bhagavan is given. We have to ask Chandubhai to do pratikaman and he will wash out and he can do completely or partly. It is responsibility of Chandubhai, not ours.
Correct.
So really, we don't. Any suffering or any stress or any botheration will come. Stop there.
Right.
First thing, keep separation with file one and ask file one to do pratikaman. You are not responsible for mistake. You are responsible if you are Tanmayakar, oneness with Chandubhai, then you are responsible. Mm. And once you are separated from Chandubhai, then Chandubhai, when he do pratikaman, he feel happiness. He doesn't do pratikaman, he feel unhappiness. Right. That much botheration to Chandubhai, not to us. Mm. So really, we should not get stressed.
Right.
Why I am not finding my mistake? What to do? Is there now? I know this type of mistake I have made, but what is root cause? I am not finding out. Don't get stressed. Whatever possible, you watch. Find out. Not possible, keep pending.
And at that time, you can do collective. That
collectively.
Is something wrong, I've done all this. This
and
is wrong.
And ask Chandubhai, whatever you feel, whatever type of mistake you have made, do pratikaman for
correct,
that.
Correct.
Very simple
very
and
simple.
Without any botheration.
No botheration. Yeah.
And inner bliss all the time. You want to ask something?
Dada Shri says here that we have to do pratikraman 2-3 times precisely and it's done.
Yes.
But then Dada Shri, even Niruma was doing pratikraman 500 and all. So
different.
How does that?
She knows fine mistake herself and for each and every mistake, this is wrong, I should not do this. So like that, she was doing pratikamana. A fine slice of each and every mistake. And not for one person, but or for other person or something happened. At the time, their understanding, these are the mistake happen. For general, or say, this is wrong, I should not do this. Oh, pure soul, this is wrong, I should not do this. I have negative thoughts for you. I feel very sorry for you. So like that, each and every, from morning till night, so many phases occurs, and in so many phases, awareness may not remain there. So for each and every phase, after some moment, she realizes and she will, what happened in the last few minutes, she will check and she wash out. So like that, she is doing pratikamana. But for ourselves, see, we don't want to compare with Niruma. We want to finish our mistake, and Dada Bhagwan has given very simple, do 3-4 times heartily and then it is finished. And one more thing, keep separation with Chandubhai and ask Chandubhai to do pratikaman. That is enough.
It should be done precisely.
Yes, mean heartily, don't precisely means just I have no, he says I am angry on somebody. This is my mistake, I should not do this, please give me, forgive me. That is enough.
Okay.
I think we'll take a stop here and we'll do samayik. We have pride or anger or deceit or greed or attachment or abhorrence or which any type of some bad habits or smoking habits or any other bad habits or anything. Simple formula, 4-step and 5-level. 4-step means this pride, this is, so first change your opinion, my this pride, I should not hurt anybody, this is wrong, I should come out from this pride, first level, first step. Second, how this is wrong, we are becoming superior, we are believing that I am superior than others, they are inferior from my side, so I am superior than, like that we are superior and we are seeing negative of others, so this is wrong, I should not see like this. Then third step, whenever any pride comes and we may hurt anybody, seeing negative of anybody, then do pratikamana. Ask file one to do pratikamana for about this pride. And fourth step, don't protect this pride. So fourth step and 5-level means by my pride I should not hurt anybody by speech or action or thoughts. Do pratikamana for that. So we are clearing first level. Second level, we are not hurting, but we have some negativity. Suppose somebody gives respect to us, we become happy and ego will, pride will elevate. And somebody may hurt, or somebody says some negative or disrespect to us, or some ignore, or giving others respect more and less respect to us, or ignore, then we feel insult. At that time, our intellect shows negativity for that person. So we want to clear second level, so don't see negativity. You understand that he has helping to come out from my pride, and whatever he has done is totally flawless, and my intellect showing negativity of that person due to my insult. If he gives respect, then positive for that person, and if some insult, then negative for that person. So this is due to my tumor of pride. So second level, if I see negative of that person, but not hurting any speech or action, not hurting directly, but inside I feel negative for that person, or say bad opinion for that person, then I have to do, means file one has to do pratikamana. So by doing such type of pratikamana, we can clear second level. Third level means somebody gives appreciate to me, oh, I will feel happiness, I will be elevate for that. That is, I become happy for my pride. That is also, we should come out from this, oh, this is not good, I should not be happy, this is relative and temporary. And sometimes whatever happen is a result of scientific circumstance. Why I should proud for this? So like that, we have, whatever happiness comes due to that pride, we should keep separation. Fourth level, we should not involve in pride. Don't be tanmayakar, involve in pride. And fifth level is jnatadrashta, means knower and seer of pride. Whatever discharge pride comes, we are just knower and seer. So this 5-level and 4-step. So for every tumor like anger or pride or deceit or greed, attachment, abhorrence, or any bad habits, for every mistake we can clear all mistake with 4-step and 5-level. Each and every level slowly, so we can understand where we are standing and how to clear these mistakes by right understanding. So now we will take for the anger. Anger is first level, first opinion, first step. Anger is wrong. I should not hurt anybody through my anger. Second, I should not, why this is wrong? This hurting me also, hurting others also. Relation will spoil. So like that, anger, why anger is wrong? Third level step, whenever anger happens with anybody, do pratikamana. And don't protect our anger. Don't defense for anger. Like that, 4-step and 5-level, will do pratikraman and awareness for every mistake, tumor of any anger, pride, deceit, greed. So we'll do anger or pride or attachment, any type of mistake you want to clear, you can start 4-step and 5-level. Suppose today we will take anger. So by our angerness, to whom we hurt, why this is wrong, we should do pratikraman for every angriness and don't protect. Like that, 4-step we will clear and 5-level. By our anger, we hurt anybody. If we are not hurting physically, but inside we are getting suffering. And so second level, we will do pratikraman for that. Like that, we will clear all tumors of mistakes. So we'll do samayik vidhi for anger.
Please repeat with me. O Sri Simandra Swami, O Dada Bhagwan, please give me strength to see file one anger with respect to 4 steps and 5 levels, and then to do the pratikraman for the anger tumor of the file one. I surrender my mind, body, speech and all karmas into the lotus feet of Simandra Swami and Dada Bhagwan. I am pure soul, 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 I am pure soul.
Jai Sachidanand. Jai Sachidanand to everybody.